the groups.
Plans and future and whatever, you know, and let's just go for a bit of
yeah, time. Okay, yes. All right.
Good momentum building up, actually.
Is it? Oh, golly, we'll keep going then. Oh, don't let it go now. You might win some. Oh, fine, OK.
There are other tracks.
I mean, you've missed the last
one. Those are, I mean, it's an hour special, so...
You haven't mentioned Was It All Worth It?
Was It All Worth It?
No, but we can only get so many tracks in 60 minutes. Just chat, your favourite songs, and a little medley at the beginning. Which is... No, we'll mention it, we can always change tracks. Which is your favourite track from the album, John?
This one?
Yes.
I don't know, it's difficult to say at this point, because we've just finished...
No, we haven't. The tape's still rolling.
No, we've just finished making it. We've just finished making the album. And at this point, you cannot...
What was the one you were just about to mention was one you...
Oh, was it? Was It All Worth It?
But you do like that one.
I do like that one, yes. It's the last track on the album.
That's why you like it.
Well, yeah. It has a semi-autobiographical feel about it.
Whose autobiography?
Well, the band. Really?
All of you.
Yeah.
Mm. You included, if you want.
Thank you. What about plans for the future? Are you going to tour?
I'll pass this on.
Have you asked each other yet whether you're going to tour? Would any of you like to tour?
Well, I wouldn't. I know they're waiting for me to say. What's it? At the moment, I don't think I'd like to tour. It's going. Oh dear. It's going back to the thing about I wanted to break the format, and as far as I'm concerned, I've been in the studio for 2 years. I mean, having done the Queen album, just before that, the Montserrat album. And I just think it would be, for me, it just wouldn't be right. I just feel it would be back to exactly what we said we wouldn't be doing. And I think it's just a matter of time. I think we just got to wait and see. And then if something comes up, then when we decide that we want to tour, we will do it. But I didn't want... personally, to tour on the same pretext as before, that here comes an album, so we go... besides, I mean, we've just, as far as I'm concerned, we've done all those big venues and everything. We've got to think of something different.
What is the new? I mean, everyone tours, and then they stop touring, and then they make albums. So is it time for people to sit down and come up with a new concept of putting yourself over to people?
Well, I think it's up to the individual. And I think, as far as Queen is concerned, my outlook on it is that we have to think of something new. And at the moment, nobody's come up with anything.
The nearest being Jean-Michel Jarre, maybe.
Well, I don't mean that way. It could mean...
Who?
It means... it just means stepping outside of Queen and things like that, which is what I did. I mean, okay, and I wanted to...
Oh, that
I mean,
guy who mimes with lasers.
That's the
idea. Anyway, it's getting there. Otherwise, we'll grow too old. You know, I'm going back to the Montreal thing. I'm glad I did that. Yeah. I would never have had that chance if we'd kept the ball rolling and kept doing... Because, I mean, over the last years, all we've done is a studio album or an album per year, and then you tour and you go around the world, and then by the time you come back, you think of the next album. You've got to... I think for us to get to this level, for us to actually sit here and talk to you about this new album, I think we would never have sort of arrived at that if we hadn't taken that 2 year off, I think. Yes, those 2 years off. I really do. It's actually sort of stepping outside of Queen, doing something and saying, we miss Queen, and then we want to come back and do something, is why I think this album sounds so fresh.
While you all still look much as you did when you started, I mean, none of you had aged an awful lot since you started.
My.
You're so kind.
God.
I'm lying. while you look much the same as you did when you started, had you thought about doing a definitive film, The Queen Story?
Well, there is a thing out there. There is a whole sort of video anthology of sort of the history of Queen out there in three extremely long volumes.
Meryl Streep.
I mean, as
Jack Nicholson plays me.
Do you mean that we actually participate actually in the acting?
Yes, that you play yourselves in the story of Queen with
boring.
The music.
Oh, no, I think that would be absolutely horrendous.
Start taking acting lessons and things like that.
Well, to be yourself.
meaning sort of, and, you know,
interesting
actually
idea.
Go to be directed by... I don't think anybody, none of us have any sort of big... I personally don't want to be a film star and things like that. I mean, I know Sting and people like that. I mean, if we wanted to do that, we would have done that a long time ago.
What do you want to do?
Well, I just want to be a boring old fart and carry on like we are.
Actually, it might sound strange just because I know, I think we built a lot of our reputation on our live stage act. But I think until we're ready to sort of, to maybe perform again, you know, till all of us are ready, then, you know, maybe we won't, but and hopefully we will at some point. I'm waffling.
it's a
I know it sounds a little odd, because we know there's a big demand there for it, but I think the time will come, we'll choose the right time.
Hopefully. Do you need to be hungry to do it, or not?
No, I don't think it's a question of that, really.
I need to be. And this is Freddie talking.
Yes.
You see, this is it. You're talking to four people of very, very different ideas, and very strong individuals. And it does need four people to actually want to do it. And I mean, one person doesn't want to do it, then you can't. And I'm afraid, I think I'm the actual spanner in the works at the moment. Mm-hmm. And I'll be very honest in saying so.
The others would like to tour?
Yes, I think so. Yes, I'm the one that doesn't want to.
Do they hate you for it?
I don't know. I don't give a damn, actually, what they think. It's just that I don't want to do it. I know. I don't think I'm letting them down or anything. It's just, I think, after all these years, I think you have to sort of believe in between the four. You have to believe in each other. And if one person doesn't want to do it for something, and if he has a grievance about it, I think one. I'd do the same if, say, Brian suddenly didn't want to do it. I mean, if one of them didn't want to do this album, we'd have to agree, because I mean, it's no point forcing somebody, especially after all. Especially after all these years, it'd be so awful. It's like you say, "Are you hungry?" Now, I agree with that. You have to be hungry, especially after all these years, to do whatever we've done all these years. Otherwise, it'd be. I don't want to bring up any names, but I hate to do that sort of slogging thing for the sake of doing it. I mean, we don't need any more money, actually, to be honest. So we don't do it for the money. But I think we do it for the music, which is, I know it's a boring thing to say, but because we still have the music in us, and I think we want, every now and again, if you stay away from it, you think, my God, I wonder how people, are they still going to accept us and things like that. That's still there, so the hunger has to be there. And I really don't think this album would have come about if we weren't still hungry for our own music. So I think we have to be interested in our thing. I mean, We're very happy with the way things have come out. And I think we would only have done it, because there was a time where I just thought, after about 2 or 3 months, I thought it was all going to sort of disband, meaning come to pieces, and we were going to disband this project. But we carried on. So I think, from my point of view, I think, and it's harder now than it ever was. I think we really have to want to do these sort of things.
So how do the rest of you get rid of the frustrations, as the three of you maybe would like to tour? Do you then think, we'll have to go and play somewhere else?
Well, he has.
Well, yes,
I've played with the Cross, and I really do enjoy that. That's a real outlet for me, and it's also different. As I say, I'm not the drummer in that band, so that's very interesting. I mean, I can live with that, and... you know, everybody has their own way of thinking. We've always done things that we've all wanted to do. And we can't, you know, possibly go on tour if one of us isn't keen. It would be as cheating, really. So there we go, you know.
So what about future projects for you, Roger? Anything coming up?
Yes, I hope to do another Cross record at some point. I'm not sure exactly when. And we'll see what happens there. But in the meantime, you know, I hope that this Queen record is well accepted. And... it'll be interesting. This is a very funny stage. We've just finished the record. Mm. And so we don't really know. We're a little bit shell-shocked, you know. We've been in the studio for a year. And so it's probably not the best time to sort of ask us, because we've got no retrospect on it. Mm. No perspective on that one.
What about you, Brian? Plans for the future? Anything that you want to get your teeth into?
Well, I've had a solo record on the cards for a long time. I've done a lot of stuff for a solo record. I just haven't quite got it in the shape that I want it yet. And I suppose I've got a taste for being a frontman as well as a guitarist. I mean, I enjoy it. I mean, I found when we got up and, you know, with Roger and John at the Queen convention thing, I got up and I just enjoyed being able to sing a bit as well as to play. I'm not a singer, but to have the freedom to be able to put ideas forward with the voice as well as the guitar, it was a good feeling.